Hey guys, DeckitSir here. In this video, I'm going to go over how to find your sensitivity and explain some strengths and weaknesses of different sensitivity ranges. My hope is by the end of this video, you'll have a better understanding of what makes a sensitivity good for you and how changing sensitivity affects the mechanics behind aiming. First off, before moving on with the video, I need to explain what centimeter per 360 means. Some of those watching may have already heard about this before, but for those of you that haven't, centimeter per 360 is a universal way of measuring your sensitivity that can easily be converted from game to game. Take Overwatch and Counter-Strike for example. A sensitivity of 10 in Overwatch is the same thing as a sensitivity of 3 in Counter-Strike. Both of these values, however, on 400 DPI are equal to 34.6 centimeters per 360. So instead of referring to the sensitivity as 10 in Overwatch, you could call it 34.6 centimeters. Finding your centimeter per 360 is as easy as getting a tape measure and measuring the distance in centimeters that it takes you to do one full 360 degree turn. And although this is the correct way of doing it, there are other ways which involve online calculators which can give you an extremely close estimate without the need of actually measuring it for yourself. I'll have a link in the description to one in case you're interested. When discussing centimeters per 360, it's important to remember that the larger the centimeter per 360 value is, the lower the sensitivity is. So therefore, a smaller centimeter per 360 value is a higher sensitivity. So that means if someone has a sensitivity of 30 centimeters per 360, and another has a sensitivity of 25 centimeters per 360, then the person using a sensitivity of 25 centimeters is using a higher sensitivity, since the distance it takes them to do one 360 is less. Now that you understand what centimeter per 360 means, I'm going to be referring to this a lot during the rest of the video. Now is also a good time to talk about DPI. DPI stands for dots per inch and is essentially how many changes in position that your mouse registers per inch of movement. For reference, the standard DPI for most mice, including most non-gaming mice, is 800 DPI. But a lot of gaming mice these days can be set anywhere between 400 DPI and 3200 DPI. Many even go well beyond that. But the thing to realize is that DPI ultimately doesn't matter when it comes to sensitivity, because a sensitivity of 1 using 800 DPI is the same thing as using a sensitivity of 2 and a DPI of 400. It can be very confusing for new players to understand this, so my recommendation is to choose a DPI that feels comfortable to use when not gaming, and then adjust your in-game sensitivity accordingly. Okay, so now that's out of the way, what makes a good sensitivity? Well, a good sensitivity in one situation might not be a good sensitivity in another, and what works for one person might not work well for someone else. A good starting point is to take into account how much desk space you have, and also how big of a mouse pad you have. As a side note, I recommend getting the biggest mouse pad that'll fit in your space, or at least one that is reasonably large. This is important because how much mouse pad space you have is going to determine your limits for sensitivity. For example, if you barely have any room to move your mouse, then naturally using a very low sensitivity is automatically less viable. The next thing to consider when it comes to choosing your sensitivity is the type of game you're playing. A more precision-based game like Counter-Strike, for example, is going to favor lower sensitivity, whereas a more movement and tracking-heavy game like Quake is going to favor a higher sensitivity. That said, there is a range of sensitivities that most good aimers fall into, that range being between 40 centimeters and 20 centimeters. That's not to say there aren't good players that use sensitivities outside this range. On the contrary, there are many decent FPS players that use sensitivities that fall outside this range, but they usually have very specific reasons as to why they do. Many Counter-Strike professionals, for example, use sensitivities as low as 55 centimeters, with some even using sensitivities closer to 80 centimeters. So what makes them so special? Well, in a map-controlled game like Counter-Strike, a lot of the aiming you need to do is done ahead of time. To add on to this, most of the aiming you do in Counter-Strike is pre-aiming and then making fast, precise micro-corrections, which are a lot easier with low sensitivities. As you can see, different games have different demands. It is for this reason that some players in certain games choose to make exceptions to the ideal sensitivity range, which again is around 40 centimeters for the low end and around 20 centimeters for the high end. Speaking of low to high end, let's talk about the strengths and weaknesses of using low sensitivity versus using a high sensitivity, as well as ones that are in between. In order for you to choose a sensitivity that best fits you, it's important to know what different sensitivities are good for. We'll start with low sensitivity, as I'm sure a lot of you have heard before, that lower sensitivity is better or that it makes your shots easier to hit. After all, it's one of the most commonly thrown around bits of advice to new players trying to improve their aim. And while it's mostly true, there's more to the story, and we'll get to that later. What low sensitivities do well is make it easier to be precise, have smoother crosshair movement, and be more consistent in high pressure situations, such as when you get nervous during a clutch and your hands start to shake. Not only does low sense make these things easier, but it also helps with things such as long distance tracking, small distance flicks, and click timing. All very appealing. But low sensitivity has its weaknesses also, and there are many. First off, low sensitivity users may struggle with running out of mousepad space, which is something I mentioned earlier. They may even find themselves having a hard time keeping up with enemies that are up close and personal, because the closer an enemy is, the faster their movements appear on your screen, which makes your chances of keeping up with them on a low sensitivity a lot lower. Another potential problem is that low sensitivity users may have a harder time turning around if an enemy sneaks up behind them, for example. They might also find it difficult to aim vertically or track extremely fast-moving targets. Higher sensitivity values, on the other hand, share a different set of pros and cons. For one, using high sensitivity allows you to track fast-moving targets more easily, and also for longer periods of time without running out of mousepad space. This is especially useful for long drawn-out fights and for games that have a long time to kill. Not only this, but the increased range of motion means that it's a lot easier to check behind you, and it's a lot easier to react to enemies in off angles, or ones that you just didn't expect them to be in. The list of pros and cons for different sensitivities goes on and on, but what you should realize is that no sensitivity is perfect. No matter what sensitivity you choose, the bottom line is to get good with a sensitivity, you need to accept it in its entirety, and then actively take action to mitigate your flaws. The last thing to know before picking your sensitivity, however, is how sensitivity changes the mechanics behind aiming. In large part, this is where the whole sensitivity is just a preference thing comes in. When aiming, there are three parts of your body that you use to manipulate the mouse: the fingers, the wrist, and the arm. In practice, there are actually several more, such as the elbow, shoulder, and chest, but for simplicity's sake, we'll just talk about the main three. Everyone uses some combination of these three, whether they're aware of it or not. But the ratios of how much of each they use depends on many things like their mouse grip, aiming style, and most importantly to this conversation, sensitivity. Someone who uses low sensitivity, for example, will usually end up using a great bit more of arm because it allows them to cover more distance in a quick swipe versus swiping the wrist, picking up the mouse, putting it back down, swiping again, picking up their mouse, moving it again, right? So instead of doing something like this, they would do something more like this. In this hypothetical situation, you can also see how a low sense user might use their wrist to micro-correct once they've made their big movements. This is just one example of how someone might use this combination. Another example could be a high sense player. Some high sense players like to plant their arms down similar to this, and mostly use their wrist to aim. But since their arm is planted, however, it becomes difficult to look up. So to remedy this, they will use their fingers like this to give them more vertical control. Another example, however, is yet another high sensitivity player. Except this time, they use their arm quite a lot. It may not be as noticeable as the low sense player from earlier, because a lot of these movements are very subtle and tiny, as this method is using a slow and smooth controlled approach to arm aiming. These are just a few examples of combinations. There is way more that I could ever show in one video, but I've shown you all this because you may find one combination to work better for you, and that's another factor that should go into choosing your sensitivity. And it's also why copying someone else's sensitivity may not give you the same results. Two people can be using the same centimeter per 360 value, but that doesn't mean they're aiming in the same way, which is why it's even more important for you to choose a sensitivity that works for you. To recap, when deciding what mouse sensitivity to use, it's important to think about a lot of things, such as how much desk space you have, what kind of games are you playing, what do those games require of you, how prepared do you need to be for flanking enemies, and the list goes on. It's best to pick a sensitivity in the range of 40 centimeters per 360 to 20 centimeters per 360, but sometimes there are exceptions. Every sensitivity has its strengths and weaknesses, and no sensitivity is perfect. Whether you choose low, medium, or high sensitivity, you're going to need to spend time working on your weaknesses, and there's no magic sensitivity that's going to change that fact. And lastly, think about what sensitivity will complement your preferred way of aiming. If you prefer to use slow and controlled mouse movements, then consider a higher sensitivity. Or if you prefer big and swift mouse movements, consider using a lower sensitivity, for example. And after all this, if you're still lost, I encourage you to experiment. Try using high, medium, and low sensitivities, and try different combinations with them as well. After all, you'll never know whether or not you like something until you try it. If you found this video informative or helpful at all, please leave a like and consider subscribing for more content like this. As always, if you guys have any questions, I'll be glad to answer them in the comments. Thanks for watching.